Hola. Hi, everybody. It's a complete honor to be amongst you. Again, I'm Noah Kaplan. I'm an artist, and I'm the president and founder of a company called Leon Speakers. We manufacture high-performance custom sound solutions in Ann Arbor, Michigan. It's a mouthful, and that's part of my presentation. You heard at the beginning, I said I was an artist, and now I'm the president of a company. It's a much different form of transformation, and I know a lot of people are here talking about transformation, so it feels good to be amongst you. Anyway, rewind 15 years. Everything was a lot different back then. We decided to start this little company, strange little company called Leon, in a little downtown spot in Ann Arbor, Michigan, with these two blokes. Both were fellow artists slash musicians slash philosophers, so we had an amazing crew for business, two musicians and an artist. It's a true recipe for success. And of course, you can see back then, that's me in the middle. Obviously heavily influenced by Bob Marley and Jean-Michel Basquiat. But we really believed in what we were doing. We really were addicted to innovation. And what we all had in common was that we all lived for music. I was a commission artist, but man, I can't even paint a picture without a piece of music playing. You know, it's what moves me, it's what drives me, it's what I live for. And these guys were the same, both amazing musicians, also pretty interesting philosophers. We did a lot of philosophizing down there, and eventually we figured out exactly what we were gonna do. This little company called Leon was there to bring artisan-level audio back. Back then, in the mid-90s, dawn of digital revolution, mega dawn of commercialized audio, little plastic boxes and big black tower boxes, and speakers just didn't look that cool. So we wanted to bring back new materials, solid hardwoods. You see behind me some of the speakers we used to build. It was all about the joinery. It was about the intrinsic value. It was about the sound quality. So we started buying all these fancy woods. We bought adequate but inexpensive machinery to do all this, and we started to learn how to build speakers, and we really started to gain some momentum. And people started coming down to this space. And you know, down in that space, it was sort of a little collaborative hub. We started meeting engineers and artists and people who were there to help us all along the way. It was a truly amazing experience. We also noticed that people sort of hung around down there. They were there, they would stay down there, and they would spend time and we'd talk about what they wanted and what they thought we can do. And eventually we had that one epiphany moment. And that moment was me, who was Noah, the underground gallery, you see that little hand-painted sign back there, and these Leon speaker guys were about to change the way that you could look at speakers. Back then, my title was actually C-3PO. And the banks didn't think it was funny, but you know, we were all about it. I was the chairman of three partial owners. I was the design guy in the middle. And so what we started to do was we started to contract with the artists that were part of the gallery space that we shared. To silkscreen pieces of their art. This is actually one of my old pieces, and you'll see at the bottom corner, that was actually what we called an acoustograph, and our first product was called Picture Sound, and people started to really like it in Ann Arbor. We started gaining some commercial success, we started working with some restaurants and interior decorators, and we thought, hey, if it's working here, let's see how it goes in New York. I'm from New York originally, it was time to go back to the homeland. I'd been in Ann Arbor for a long time. So we go into New York City, downtown Manhattan, to one of the most, let's call it, venerated audio stores in New York City. And we brought Picture Sound and we said, here's the future of audio. The future of audio is on the wall. You're gonna be able to print custom silk screens. You can have different options and choice. And he picked up that speaker and he looked at me. He looked at my friend, he said, well, this is the worst speaker I've ever seen in my entire life. And it was then that, you know, your balloon pops and all of a sudden your jaw drops. But you know what he says? He looks over and he points to his window, but he said, you know, you see that TV in the window? He pointed to a plasma TV. And back then, a plasma TV was groundbreaking. It was $23,000 for a 42. It wasn't even available at Costco. So gave us a shot. He said, if you could make those speakers look exactly like that TV, I would consider putting in my window because I see where you guys are going. We know that the flat panel revolution is on its way. And we went back to our little Ann Arbor gallery, our quaint little space, and we transformed the back room into a laboratory, and we dove deep. What makes a TV sound great? Is a TV a stereo? TV isn't a stereo. We started collaborating with different acousticians and engineers and material scientists, and eventually, we figured out how to make custom speakers that would exactly match a flat panel TV. And that was a transformation. But that's not the transformation I'm here to talk about today. That's a much different form. Here we are, fast forward. We're in this new factory space. And now, picture sound is in the distant past, right? And now what do? We manufacture high-quality, custom-tailored sound solutions for plasma TVs built to match the exact size and finish of any display.
Yeah.
Woo! But that was really far from where we started. I have no idea how we got there. And in fact, three factories later, my business partners are gone. They're all philosophizing. I'm here left to run the company. You know, so I take on this new persona, and one day, I drive over to the factory, it's a cold winter day, and I drive in, and I look at the parking lot in this new space, and all of a sudden, I notice that all the spots are taken. What's going on? What happened? Where did all these people come from? I'm running a business all of a sudden? Wait, I'm an artist. How is an artist supposed to know how to run a business? How am I supposed to go from painting and doing sculpture and carving to reading spreadsheets and balance sheets and AR and AP and other acronyms that I didn't understand? I bought a sports coat. I cut my hair. But you know what? I was absolutely determined to learn what was going to happen next to us. We really were proud to be there, but then I started having this recurring dream. And this recurring dream was the dream the factory roof was pulled off, and a dragon sort of descended on the factory, and it was dancing around the factory in our production line with a foggy head. And it was mocking me, but it was silent. But the machines were loud, but it was silent. And it was mocking me, and it had a foggy head, and it kept coming to me. And one day, I woke up my wife, who's in the audience right now. It's her birthday today. Happy birthday, Helen. I couldn't do any of this without that woman. Thank you. I love you. Emotional. Sorry. So anyway, I wake her up and I say, Helen, I think I finally got it. I'm gonna build a really loud dragon. I'm gonna go back to the factory. We're gonna build a sound sculpture. And she looked at me with bleary eyes, and you know what happened? She just went, again. So I rolled up to the factory the next day, and you know what? We did decide that we were gonna build this audio dragon. It was gonna be an interactive sound sculpture. It was gonna breathe massive audio, 5 channels of high-powered audio. It was gonna have fiber optic lighting. It was going to be machined. It was going to be 17 foot long. It was going to be true to scale. It was going to be an imperial dragon. It was going to have wisdom. Hopefully, this foggy-headed dragon would finally make sense. And we were going to bring this out. We were going to tour it around the world. And we're going to bring it to our industry. And yeah, we're going to reassert that speakers don't have to be little black boxes. You don't have to hide them next to your TV. You could have much more. You could have whatever you want. There's so much more. And you know what? I brought a little movie to share with you guys today. It's called The Making of a Dragon, an interactive sound sculpture. So anyway, here's that little movie.
Thank you.
The values and the mission of our company. And the values and the mission of the company are now clear to everyone. It's the rebirth of the mission. We wanted to breed a culture that blends art with audio and business with bohemia so that we could create things that people hadn't seen. We brought one of our sound sculptures that you'll see behind me. You can see it upstairs in the lab. It's called the Trithon. And now our products had a little more style. And you know what? Even our clients actually better understood us. This is a recent project downtown in Ann Arbor, Michigan, Cafe Lena, where this transformation continues. And our clients help us with this. And the people we love and know help us with this. This is a sound sculpture that plays off the architecture in a room. This is the new on-wall speaker. And all of a sudden, this is their dragon. And what does the shop call this project now? A dragon. Of course, I'm always left with more questions and extreme gratitude for all the people who helped me get to where I am today. They're in the audience. They're all around Metro Detroit area, all around the world. I thank them wholly. Finally, my last question, because we all go through transformation with relationships, family, friends, and business. It is the year of the dragon. It's almost over, but I leave with just one question. What's your dragon? Thank you, everybody. Truly appreciate it.